FBI investigation is underway involving Senator Ron Calderon of Montebello.
L.A. County Assessor John Noguez.
Wendy Gruel, a leading candidate to be the new mayor of Los Angeles.
Randy Economy at Los Cerritos News was the first to ask some of those questions.
This story is plain and simple, government corruption.
The center of this is the political family, the Calderons. You have State Senator Ron Calderon. You have Tom Calderon, who is a two-term former assemblyman, former State Senator Chuck Calderon. It's about power. It's about millions of dollars. And it's about taxpayer money. Here there was a young, dynamic Latino family from East Los Angeles who basically said, hey, let's run for public office. And once they got into their first office, they got a taste of what it was all about. Realized, God, we can make a killing off this thing. We can make so much money and manipulate multi-million dollar contracts with water boards and air quality district boards and trash contractors and hospitals and whatever they can get their hands on.
We're here in Commerce, right up the 5 freeway on Washington Boulevard, and this very unassuming building is the home of the Central Basin Municipal Water District. We believe this is where the den of corruption is taking place here in Southeast Los Angeles County.
What we uncovered when we did a public records request was we found Calderon landing several contracts.
In 2009, we were given notice of intent to award $1 million contract. The staff of the Water District recommended us for the contract. That contract was given to Old Timers Foundation that Tom Calderon sat on the board of. I was floored. This was the largest single contract my firm was ever to have won.
It's a private club. You can't be in the Calderon Club unless you're a Calderon.
I felt defeated. I felt defeated by the system of corruption.
These guys are finally getting caught. And I applaud the FBI. Thank you, FBI, for doing their job. What the took them so long? You got this political machinery, politics spun completely out of control, and it's not getting any better. And I don't know if they're just gonna have to go ahead and have the feds come in and shut down Sacramento and do a massive sweep to go ahead and start breaking out handcuffs. But something's gotta happen, it's gotta happen soon.
There's no transparency, and the no transparency turns into corruption, and the corruption turns into wasting taxpayer dollars. And everybody out there should be angry about this.
I think this is gonna be the end of the Calderon dynasty. I really do. This story that we're uncovering right now, today, I think it's got the potential of being the biggest political scandal in California state history.
We'd like to talk to you about the scandal surrounding your office. LA County Assessor John Noguez ignored our questions, wouldn't talk to us, just smiled and waved goodbye. Attorney David Yosefian says he's seen firsthand how the assessor's office offers to help people who make political contributions.
The culture that Mr. Noguez has instilled in a very short time in the assessor's office is corrupt.
Noguez is on a paid leave of absence in the wake of suspicion stirred up by one of his appraisers. Scott Shenter lowered property values on multi-million dollar homes and left people asking why.
Here's a perfect case where you had a condo that was basically brought down in assessed value by 69%. Here's another one of 70%.
Randy Economy at Los Cerritos News was the first to ask some of those questions. You're looking at what's being called Shenter's List. Impressive properties all over Southern California, like this one in Beverly Hills worth $7.4 million. Shenter reduced it to 4.8. This Santa Monica home worth $2.7 million, reassessed to 1.7. This mansion on Beverly Boulevard worth $6.2 million, Shenter lowered the value to 3.9.
It's a classic pay-to-play situation.
Economy discovered many of the homeowners who benefited from the lower property values were contributors to Noguez's campaign for assessor. Many of those people had hired tax agent Ramin Solari, who helped Noguez raise $1 million for his campaign.
To have this type of access between John Noguez and property tax agents who fund his campaign as political wishes is just an outrage to people.
So how were the property values lowered so drastically without a legitimate explanation and without anyone catching on? We've been digging through dozens of documents at the assessor's office. We came across one property in Brentwood now under investigation, and this case involves several of the key players.
This is a 5-bedroom country English home in Brentwood. In 2007, it was listed for sale at $8.4 million. But the guy who bought it, Hushan Nanvar, claims he only paid $3.7 million for it and insists That's all it's worth. He wasn't happy when appraisers from the assessor's office kept valuing his property between $6 million and $8 million. That happened several times. So then Nanbar hired tax agent Ramin Salari, who appealed the decision. Salari is now under investigation. Within a few months, the value of the property was placed on the tax rolls at $3.7 million. You can see here a line was drawn across the $6.8 million, and in handwriting, the value was lowered to $3.7 million. Who signed off on this? Take a look. John Noguez's people, Scott Shenter, who was arrested, has not posted bail and is still in jail. And this man, Mark McNeil, now under investigation and on paid leave. We tried to get a response from McNeil, but he wanted nothing to do with us.
No comment.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
We also tried to talk with the homeowner, Nanbar, but he also refused to comment.
Husheng, your property is under investigation.
Excuse me. You guys cannot have a camera in here, okay?
Nanbar called back the same day to say he's done nothing wrong, that he hired tax agent Salari, and that whatever Salari did was done without his knowledge. But attorney Yosefia says how John Noguez has run the assessor's office is crystal clear.
There's only one conclusion to draw, that the LA County assessor's office was for sale. And that if you have given money to Mr. Noguez, and that if you were there to give money again, you're going to get special treatment that you and I would never be able to get.
In our next report,
if every taxpayer in LA doesn't stand up and say this is an outrage,
the documents that may have fooled members of the Assessment Appeals Board.
I don't know what people are thinking.
And this afternoon, we learned our story got results. This afternoon, we got a call from the LA County Assessor's Office telling us that based on our investigation, they began looking into the property we focused on, and they discovered there is no legitimate reason for the dramatic drop in value. We spoke to Luis Reyes from the Assessor's Office, and this is what he had to say.
When Fox 11 brought this to our attention, we looked at the Assessment Appeals Board for further information that we didn't have access to. After reviewing the information, we restored the value to $7,459,000 from the previous amount.
And that previous amount that Shenter had lowered the property value to was $3.7 million. The homeowner will now receive a bill for back taxes owed since 2008. And again, the real property value is now $7.4 million. And the assessor's office says that they will also refer this case to the DA.
Investigators with search warrants raided the home of LA County Assessor John Noguez this morning as part of a corruption investigation looking into whether property tax values were slashed in exchange for campaign contributions. KKL9 political reporter Dave Bryan is live in Cerritos with more on the allegations and today's raids. Dave?
Sharon, the search warrants were flying at a dozen locations between here and Phoenix, Arizona. It's a story that many people have been reading about. The headlines have been in for months now in the LA Times. But before that, this small community newspaper with a staff of five has been pursuing this story now for 4 months. Investigators showed up with search warrants at the home of LA County Assessor John Noguez in Huntington Park and 11 other locations, including the Arizona home of private tax agent Ramin Salari. They were looking for evidence in a wide-ranging corruption probe, reportedly including allegations of bribery and campaign money laundering.
Can we put the College Board story on here, too?
At the tiny community news in Cerritos, where reporter Randy Economy has been aggressively working the story since January, he says he has found strong evidence of possible corruption.
I think this is basically a classic pay-to-play scheme that he's been wrapped up in for quite some time, and I think he finally got caught.
The raids follow reports that the assessed values of hundreds of properties, including many huge mansions on the west side of LA, were slashed by Noguez's office. Cuts of more than $1 billion in total, and the owners of those properties were encouraged to contribute generously to his political campaign fund. Noguez has worked in the assessor's office for more than 20 years, while he has also served as a Huntington Park City Councilman. Linda Cabrillo, who ran against him for council in 2007, says he was already getting big contributions then from property owners whose tax bills were cut.
And it wasn't that this individual had the ability to raise so much money. It was the source of income.
In fact, Economy believes there were already signs of possible pay-for-play activity before Noguez became the county assessor when he was working in the office and running for Huntington Park City Council.
I think that that was his training ground. And I think that a lot of these cities in Southeast Los Angeles County have gone unchecked. And now all of a sudden he's on a huge stage as the largest county tax assessor in America. And he basically thinks this is Huntington Park City Hall.
The publisher of the paper says the Community News was the first to call for Noguez's resignation.
And I just made a case that this gentleman doesn't know what he's doing. And by the way, he's going to get audited now.
Well, keep in mind now that John Noguez has not been convicted of anything. In fact, he hasn't even been charged with anything yet. Noguez says he's done nothing wrong. There was no exchange of favors here. And he says, of course, at a time when real estate values were falling all across the country, he would reduce assessments in Southern California. Reporting live from Cerritos, Dave Bryan, KCAL 9 News.
It's new at 6. 74's Patrick Healy joins us live at Los Angeles City Hall. And now, Patrick, what exactly is Rule saying about these allegations?
Well, Lucy and Shaq, we spoke to her a short while ago. She denies anything improper. And, of course, office holders are entitled to campaign. The allegation here is that not only did she spend an inordinate amount of time at political events, but many times she was helped by city staffers.
This is modeled after...
Wendy Gruhl at an L.A. City Hall committee meeting this afternoon, testifying as city controller. The allegation is her calendar shows her dedicating city time and city staff to her campaign for mayor.
So we got calls from inside of her controller's office and saying, I'm sick and tired of working for her mayoral campaign.
Reporter Randy Economy made a public records request for the Los Cerritos Community News and eventually got 600-plus pages. Wendy Gruhl's office calendar shows years of campaigning for mayor on taxpayers' dollar, headlined Economy's article when it went online Monday.
What shocked us when we saw the controller calendar was the fact that there were so many campaign events on it.
Former federal prosecutor and radio talk show host Kevin James is a City Hall outsider in the field running for mayor. Citing the report at a news conference, James slammed Gruhl and called on the city attorney to investigate. Late afternoon, Gruhl responded with a denial she's done anything improper.
I think it's silly season from someone who is running for office.
Gruhl said she works 18-hour days to make time for campaigning around her controller duties. But what of the fact calendar pages showing the names of city controller employees at campaign events? Gruhl insists they were volunteering.
If they choose after work to do what they want to do, that's their option.
It's amazing how many staff volunteers she has then.
James acknowledged that Economy had told him of the investigation months ago. Gruhl alleges bias. Economy denies that. Tonight, not commenting on Gruhl's calendar are the two City Hall candidates for mayor, Jan Perry, Eric Garcetti. Today, both said they will make available their calendars. Live at LA City Hall, Patrick Healy, NBC4 News.